Chucking a sickie. It's as Australian as meat pies and offshore detention. But the Labor Party is currently trying to make it much harder for government MPs to call in sick.
They've indicated they won't be participating in a pairing arrangement with the government, in a move that experienced political analysts such as myself are calling some bullshit.
Pairing means if a government MP can't be present for a vote due to sickness or travel obligations, an opposition MP will also not vote. It's a kind, selfless act, which is why Labor says they won't have a bar of it. Malcolm Turnbull has previously declared he has a working majority, so the Labor Party is looking to test him on this, no matter what's at stake.
So ministers will have to skip these overseas meetings to be at every sitting of the parliament?
Not if the government's got a working majority, which is what the Prime Minister said.
So Labor's going to jeopardise the proper functioning of parliament just to prove a petty point.
In other words, they had a chance to be the bigger person here. Instead, they chose to be Peter Dinklage.
Meanwhile, Christopher Pyne, the Joffrey of Australian politics, has labelled the move as Dickensian.
I never read about bipartisan pairing arrangements in Great Expectations. But then again, I never read Great Expectations.
The issue is that if a person is sick, or if they have a family emergency, Labor is indicating that they shouldn't have any rights in the workplace at all.
Pyne is understandably annoyed because not having any rights in the workplace is the coalition's policy. And wait till Pyne finds out about this MP who even thinks funerals aren't a good enough reason to allow pairing.
It is not appropriate for a funeral to take precedence over votes in the parliament about the integrity of the government.
Christopher takes voting in the House very seriously. In fact, I believe we have footage of what he does during a vote. I would run away. But the coalition is right to be outraged, as they always took great interest in the welfare of Labor politicians during the Gillard government. Look at how concerned coalition MP Warren Ench was when Labor MP Craig Thompson fell ill and presented a doctor's certificate.
But it says you've got abdominal pain. What is an abdominal pain? Is he got constipation or you don't know.
Warren Ench there, suffering from a severe case of brain gastro. Sadly for Craig Thompson, his career was brought to an end by something below the abdomen. But one man in the coalition acknowledges the way his party treated Labor's requests for pairs during the Gillard years was wrong.
Well, look, I'm just saying that if those decisions were made, then I think those decisions were also wrong. There you go.
There you have it, a politician admitting a decision their party made was wrong. It's finally happened!
As for Labor, they could learn a thing or two about bipartisanship from this guy.
The Australian people expect all sides of politics to work in the national interest, in the interest of the people, not just themselves. So I understand that we need to make this parliament function, and we will be up for that.
There you have it, a politician failing to live up to their past statements. But to be fair, that was one whole month ago. Sorry guys, party's over.